team here at Bishop McNamara High School. It is wonderful to have each of you here, including our parents, guardians, coaches, teammates, faculty, staff, and administration. I want to thank you for taking the time and effort to come to this special event. This year, Bishop McNamara has 10 student athletes participating in this ceremony, with several more students to follow later in the school year, which is a tremendous accomplishment for these individuals, as well as a school of our size. Among the more than 2 million students who participate in high school athletics nationwide, less than 1% receive a college athletic scholarship. Each of these students have spent countless hours honing their athletic skills to earn these kinds of scholarships. I want to congratulate each of you, as today marks a culmination of your dedication and success as student athletes. As the famous John Wooden once said, success is peace of mind, which is a direct result of self-satisfaction and knowing you did your best to become the best you are capable of becoming. You have each sacrificed much time and energy to get to this point, and we wish you much success, not only athletically, but personally and professionally, when you graduate Bishop McNamara in a few months. Remember, be more concerned with your
sacrifice for their ability to join a team and to succeed. And so this day brings us much joy. We thank you for being with us in this celebration. Today is truly a day to celebrate as we come together to celebrate our young men and women. As Dr. Vanderwag mentioned, with 10 student athletes today, we certainly expect more. We'll have another ceremony in the spring where we expect more of our student athletes to be present before you. So for all the teammates, all the seniors that exist in the stands that know this day is coming, for all of our underclassmen and women that are sitting in the stands that know this day is coming, we want this day to serve as motivation. We want these young men and women that sit before you to serve as role models for the work ahead, the work that needs to be done. We know the work that is here is not the work that ends today. We know that they sit before us as examples to inspire those in front of you. So while we come together today to celebrate these young men and women, we also serve, we also accept their motivation. They serve for us each day. And so to help us welcome these young men and women, we have a young man that's with us today, an alumnus from the class of 1997, Mr. Michael Brooks. Mr. Brooks has served with us for many years. He has been a tremendous role model for our young men and women. As class of 1997, salutatorian of his class, he went on to Harvard University, where he played football. He also was a three-sport star here at Bishop McNamara. And he's come to share some words and encouragement with us today. And so without further ado, I'd like to welcome Mr. Michael Brooks, class of 1997.
Morning.
It's always an honor and a pleasure to come back to Bishop McNamara. As you know, we have small classes here, so it forms that family atmosphere. And today is a day of celebration, like Mr. Johnson said. So don't hold back on the applause and the tears that may come from this moment. I want to congratulate everyone that are on this table, especially Kamari, who I've had a pleasure of working with. And also, one guy that I met a while ago when he was 9 years old. He came to one of my camps that I was doing a speed agility camp at, and he worked very hard. And he had a nameplate on his shirt, and I recognized the name. And at the end of that, the first day, I asked him who his uncles were, and they were his uncles. He was one of the kids that worked hard, and at that age, you always want to finish first, so a lot of kids would back up in line and line up next to somebody they knew that they could beat. But this kid never did that. He always worked hard and he gave it 100%. And today I'm proud to see him sign his scholarship to the University of Maryland, BC, Cal Benjamin. Four years ago, this process started. It started with sacrifice and investment. The most obvious thing that people invest is money. It costs money to go to Bishop McNamara. And parents and the student alike, you guys made the decision to come to this school. Okay, and it was an investment in your future, an investment in a moment like this. But there's something that's more precious than money. If I invest $10, I know what I have to do to recoup that. But there's something that I can't get back, and that's time. Okay, an investment in time. Parents, you guys invested time to get your kids to school on time every day. My mom traveled 1 hour from St. Mary's County every day to get me here to Bishop McNamara. So all the kids that are signed today, I want you guys to stand up and give your parents a round of applause for giving you to this moment. In this day, practice, sacrifices, friends. When I left from my public school in St. Mary's County, I had to sacrifice friends to make true friends, the ones from Bishop McNamara, the ones that stood beside me and fought beside me for 4 years. Now, lastly, this sport is gonna take you places that you know, you might not normally go, so use your sport to take you places. Don't let the sport use you. This sport took me to Harvard University. This sport helped me make connections that I would not normally make. And it also took me to different places in the world. I traveled to Europe, played in Europe. And it gave me a good education that I take with me every day. So there are a couple things that I want to leave you with. How do you want to be remembered? This next 4 years is going to be, for most of us, the last time that we play competitive sports. So what's the legacy you want to leave behind? Our sport life is only so long, but our life takes us for forever. So what you do with it is in your hands. Thank you for your time, and God bless you.
Thank you, Ms. Brooks. It was certainly a pleasure to hear you speak today, and certainly a pleasure watching Michael run around the field, of course, and certainly as a track star, we certainly enjoyed watching Michael while he was here. And so just to tell you a bit more about today, our format is very simple. Today we're going to hear from our celebrants. Our student athletes, all of our parents that are here with us today, certainly the sacrifice that you make, the time and energy that you spend, we truly appreciate and we recognize success in this moment, and we say congratulations to you as well on this day. We also want to recognize our faculty members that are here with us. Certainly we know that the partnership that these student athletes that are here today, they come in partnership with our faculty members. And so for all the teachers that are here today, we want to recognize you and we want to say thank you for being with us today. We want to say thank you for your contribution to our student athletes. We also want to recognize our coaches. We certainly understand and recognize the many moments that our student athletes are in the hands of our coaches. So all of the coaches that are here today, we want you to be recognized as well. So coaches, thank you very much for your contribution. And to our administration, we want to say thank you for being with us. We certainly know that this opportunity to recognize these student-athletes also brings joy to us as an institution. So we thank our student-athletes, we thank our coaches, we thank our parents and teachers for coming together to help us celebrate and share in this day. So thank you to our administration as well. And without further ado, I know we're here to celebrate our celebrants that are here in front of us. And so, we want to hear from the student athletes that are in front of us. And so, we are going to do so at this time. And our first celebrant that we honor is Mr. Kyle Benjamin.
My name is Kyle Benjamin. career at the University of Maryland, Baltimore County, this fall of 2016.
Secondly, I'd like to thank all my friends and all my teammates, for those truly my brothers.
during training camp, throughout these first 4 years, training camp is literally the worst thing ever. But that's what makes random people you see on the street and people that just join the team and the actual family. And that brings the coaches together.
Ladies and gentlemen, next is Mr. Kamari Murray.
Hello, I'm Kamari Murray, and I'll be attending Concord University. Firstly, because it has my major in athletic training, and because the school has also given me a chance to participate in both sports that I love. I've been running track and football. I've been running track since I was 6 years old, and playing football since I was 6 years old. And without it, I'm not too sure what I'd do with my free time. It's just something that's instilled in me, something that I feel like I need to do. First off, I would like to thank God for blessing me with the athletic talents to go to the next level, and for also putting the correct people in a place to help me maximize my opportunities and to push me to become a better person. I'd like to thank my pound ball coaches, Coach Clark, Coach Bird, who helped develop me when I was in middle school and at a young age. I'd also like to thank my Westlake High School coaches, because my ninth grade year I used to go to Westlake High School and play football. And they were real mentors to me. Coach Curtis was my head coach. Coach Wade was my position coach, my wide receiver coach, who taught me most of the fundamentals of playing football and being a receiver. I would also like to thank all the faculty and staff at Bishop McNamara, because you really encouraged me and helped me become a better person. I actually do see that family aspect that everybody always talks about. It's not false, it's true. And it took me to really my senior year to actually realize how much support that you all showed. I'd like to thank my former McNamara coaches, Coach DeBose, Coach Vaughn, Coach Rich. I'd like to thank my track coach, Coach Chapel. Coach Durham. My sprint coach helped me excel on the track as well. I'd like to thank all my current football coaches, Coach Daniels, being such an inspirational person. Just always teaches you to push through all you gotta have at once, is what he would always say. Coach Jamal for being a funny guy in practice, always keeping it live, excited, but always pushing as well. Coach Joey, just a great guy, our offensive coordinator. He's actually one of the coaches that taught me the most that I was since I've been here. Helping build up my football IQ and schemes and things like that. Taught me the smarts in that portion of the game. Coach G, for giving me the opportunity to come here, coming out recruiting me and talking to me and just being a great guy that he is, a great role model. And Coach Ellis, my position coach, just a great guy. I mean, that's probably the coach that I'm closest to here. So you can talk to him about anything. He's just a real good person and even a better coach. I also like to thank my teammates. I mean, without y'all, like y'all really like my brothers. Y'all don't even understand, this experience wouldn't be the same, especially my best friend, Xavier. That's my man. Chad, Lamar, Brian, I'm not going to forget you, Brian. And everybody else, all my good friends. I appreciate y'all. And also want to thank my mom and my dad for being there for me and doing everything that you can to help me succeed in this process, because it's been long and hard. A lot of coaches and things like that have been doubting me because of my size and and didn't want to bring me in just because my weight, my height, and y'all been there to help me, take me around the camps, spend a lot of money, always encourage me, things like that. And y'all been hard on me, always telling me I need to eat more, and be in the weight room, and things like that. But I really love y'all, and without y'all, none of this would be possible. And I want to thank you, Mom, also for showing me all the love that you do. I mean, I never felt any love, the type of love that you give me, I never felt anywhere else. When I come in the room and hug you before I go to sleep, every night, give you a kiss. I mean, it means the world to me.
Sorry, son. Sorry, baby.
Next, we'd like to hear from Miss Bonnie Stiles.
Freshman year when I left school early to come see my big brother Taylor signed to the University of Maryland to play baseball.